Don't you just love it when you come to church and the pastor preaches on money? It's like the last thing that we want to hear is the sermon on the amount, right? You get that? Sermon on the amount. That's just a little stewardship joke you can share with your friends. Well, here's a stat that might shock you. If pastors talked about money as often as Jesus talked about money, there would be a sermon on the topic every 3 weeks. Jesus talked about money and possessions more than any other subject recorded in the Gospels. Unfortunately, we can tend to look at the subject of giving as what God or the church wants from us rather than what they want for us. If we're going to give, that means that we must also give up, right? If we're going to do for another, that means that we must not do for ourselves. And that sounds like I'm denying myself, and denial doesn't sound like very much fun, does it? This is why a passage like 2 Corinthians 9:7 can seem like nonsense. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. When you really dig into Scripture and see just what God has done for us through Christ, the only word that does any sort of justice is generosity. Because Christ died for my sin and rose to life to restore me to the Father, heck yeah, I'm cheerful. Heck yeah, I'd be happy to share some of what God has blessed me with as a blessing for you. And the great irony in all this is that in God's economy, we can experience joy in generosity rather than suffering from denying ourselves. Through Christ, God is restoring all things to Himself, not just me and you, but also plenty who don't know Him yet. We've already learned that we're invited to partner with God on His mission. He's generous to invite us and generous to provide us with the very resources that can be used to draw others to Him. Again, in 2 Corinthians 9:12 through 15, Paul writes, "This service that you perform," meaning giving generously to meet the spiritual, physical, and emotional needs of others, "is not only supplying the needs of the Lord's people, but is also overflowing into many expressions of thanks to God. Because of this service by which you've proved yourselves, others will praise God for the obedience that accompanies your confession of the gospel of Christ, and for your generosity in sharing with them and with everyone else. And in their prayers for you, their hearts will go out to you because of the surpassing grace God has given you. Thanks be to God for this indescribable gift." Did you catch all of that? When we give, we are a part of the movement of the living God to reach lives that haven't been reconciled to their Father in heaven. And when they come to know Him, they will praise Him. And then they will lift us, the givers, up in prayer. And thus the givers become the receivers. There really is power in generosity. It's not about what God wants from you, it's about what He wants for you. May we be a people characterized by generosity.